We are going to send domain traffic for a website through Fastly CDN. So I've got a website here and my content is just stored on GitHub pages. And I've got a domain that I bought and I want to point that at my website through the CDN. So I've got my DNS settings ready as well. I'm in Porkbun, but the step should work for whatever provider you're using. And we're going to create a CDN service for the domain. We're going to point that service at the origin host, which is where our website content is stored. In my case, that's the GitHub pages address. And then we're going to update the DNS records to point the domain at Fastly. So when someone visits the domain, the CDN service will return either content fetched from the origin host or a cached copy of it that's stored on the Fastly network at the edge. In that case, we don't even have to make a request to the origin to give the user the content they requested. So I'm going to sign up for a Fastly account. I am going to go through the process of verifying the account, and then when I log in for the first time, I'm going to get this guided flow. If you're using an older account, you'll see a slightly different flow. In that case, check out the documentation for the steps. So I'm going to enter the domain that I bought, but if you don't have a domain yet, you can still try the CDN out. Just don't enter a domain here. In my case, I'm using the www. Version of it, and my domain is sue.codes. And then my host, that's my GitHub IO address, and yours is wherever your site content is stored. So it might be an AWS bucket, for example. And you can choose any service name you like. And I am going to go ahead and deploy. At this point, Fastly is going to set up my CDN service and deploy it to the network, and it's going to give us updates as it completes that process. It shouldn't take too long, hopefully. And once that's complete, we can go ahead and test the service just to make sure it's returning the content from the host. And mine is looking good. So now I want to send my domain traffic through this service. So we have guides linked for popular DNS providers. You can check through them for whatever one you're using. Again, in my case, it's Porkbun, but I don't actually need the docs because it's going to be so easy. So I'm going to need two CNAME records for my domain. One is just to verify that I actually own the domain, and one is to go ahead and send my traffic to Fastly from the domain. So first of all, I'm going to grab the Acme challenge value. I'm going to go into my DNS settings. I'm going to add a new record and I'm going to choose CNAME as the type. And I use _acme-challenge followed by the subdomain that I'm interested in setting up. In my case, that's www.1. And I copy in the value that I grabbed from the Fastly account. And then I add that new record. I pop back into Fastly. And now I want a second CNAME record in my DNS settings. If you already have a DNS CNAME record for the subdomain you're working with, you're going to want to edit that instead of adding a new one. For me, it's a brand new domain, so I don't have any records yet. So this time I'm adding one for the www.subdomain, and this is going to actually send people who visit that domain to the Fastly service. And again, I'm pasting the value that I copied from Fastly. I'm going to go ahead and add that record as well. And I'm going to let Fastly know that I am ready to set this up. At this point, it's going to verify that I own the domain using that first CNAME record. Then it's going to grab me a TLS certificate so that my users can visit the content through my domain safely. And this might take a few minutes, so you can go away and come back if you like. That's mine ready. Let's take a look. Yep, that's all looking good. And I can find out a bit more about what's happening in the network using my browser tools. I'm in Chrome here. And if I right click and I choose inspect, and then I open up the network tab and reload the page, I can select the requests in there and find out more information. So if I scroll down, I'm going to get to the Fastly headers. I can even see things like the POPs that are delivering my response. And your browser tools will likely have a couple of different ways to test performance as well, so it's worth having a look in there. All right, back in my Fastly account, I'm going to finish, and that is going to put me into my new service where I can take a look around. Now, ideally, Fastly is going to cache my content and return it straight to my visitors from the cache. But if I make a change to my website, maybe I change the design, and I actually want Fastly to stop sending that cached version to update it from my origin, I can purge the cache instantly using this dropdown. And there are tons of other settings in the service. We're going to take a look at a few of them. I can set Fastly up to make my user experience more reliable. I'm going to show you one example of that by adding a synthetic response to handle errors from my origin. So if my website returns a 404 error because a resource can't be found, I'm going to get Fastly to handle that for me. So if we pop back for a second into my origin website and see what happens when I try to open a page that doesn't exist. And I'm getting this default error. It's not a great experience. I think we could make that better. So back in Fastly, I'm going to clone my service so that I can make changes to it. I'm going to scroll down to the content section. I'm going to look through that section until I find the 404 synthetic response. I'm going to switch that on. And you can include any HTML you like in here. I just want to make mine look a little bit more like the rest of my website. So I save it, and then I activate this new version of my service. And that's going to make version 2 the active version. So once we've done all that, I'm going to pop back into my website at the domain that I'm serving through Fastly so that I can check this response. And I'll just try another page that I know doesn't exist. And there we go, I'm getting the response that I added. It's a little bit better. I can get my visitors back on track. It's not quite so jarring. So before we finish up, let's take a quick look at some of the other options in your service. Later on, I'm going to set my DNS to forward my Apex domain to the www. Version because my domain registrar lets me do that. You can alternatively get Fastly to do that for you. In that case, you're going to need to add your Apex domain to the service and to your TLS, and you'll need A records to do that. All the steps for that are in the docs. And you'll see tons of other settings that you can switch on and off, like Image Optimizer, which is very handy if your site has a lot of images in it. You can also switch on things like DDoS protection. It's well worth having a look through these. And once you've got some traffic flowing through Fastly, you'll be able to gain insights into what's happening in the observability dashboards. So I've switched here into a different service for another website that I set up earlier. It's already got some traffic coming through it, so we can get a better look at the observability dashboards. And as you can see, there's lots of different information in there. It all just helps you to make sure you're getting the best performance you can from your site. We have lots more tips and tricks in the Fastly documentation.